Welcome to this Made for Success audio program. The audio you are listening to is designed to turn your potential into performance, succeed in every area of your life, and achieve your dreams. Now sit back and relax as our featured speaker begins.
How to Master the Art of Effective Time Management. In How to Master the Art of Effective Time Management, your expert productivity success coach, Omar Periu, will teach you all the correct ways of achieving whatever you set out to do. Today, effective time management is a must for all of us who want to achieve success. And Omar Periu knows what he's talking about. One of the world's leading authorities on success, sales, and sales management, Omar Periu has trained over two-thirds of the Fortune 500 companies and over a million people in the last 10 years. In this tape series, you will learn how to manage your time, overcome procrastination, establish priorities, delegation, and much, much more. There is something here for anyone who is looking for ways to increase their productivity. And now, the master motivational teacher, Omar Periu.
Welcome. Before I begin talking about the importance of managing your time wisely, I wanted to take, or should I say borrow, just a few moments to thank you for investing both your money and your most valuable asset, your time, in my time management program. The goal of this program is that you will be able to manage your time more effectively in both your business and personal life by the end of these tapes. But you must apply what I teach you on the tapes. So let's get started. Time has no master, but how do most people treat time? Did you hear I just referred to borrowing time? That's a funny way to word it, don't you think? We all talk about borrowing time. Someone comes into your office with, "Can I borrow a minute of your time?" Let me ask you, can anybody really borrow time from you? Absolutely not. When you think of it logically, everybody knows you can't really borrow time, right? Well then, let me ask you another question. Why is it that we treat time as though it was something on a loan? Something we could, not taking ownership or showing pride of ownership, borrow, use, and then conveniently return when we're done. Oh, and the best part, if we could borrow time, the use of it would be at no cost to ourselves, right? We wouldn't have to worry about how we spent our time because it costs us nothing to use it. It is free, but available in limited quantities. We didn't have to purchase time, and we didn't have to take anything from our pockets to maintain time. We're just borrowing it for a while from the ever-generous timekeeper. We'll return time when we're done, and we can get it back whenever we feel like it, free of charge. After all, we're just borrowing a little time, right? Yeah, when we get into a time crunch, we just say, "Excuse me, Mr. Timekeeper, hate to bother you and all, but may I have one more little cup of time to add to the day, so I can put a few more items on the burner before I leave work today? Thanks. I'll pay you back when I get some spare time next week." What do you say? What does time say? Time says, "Take a reality check, my friend." It would be great if that's how it really worked, wouldn't it? Unfortunately, even though many of us manage our time as if we had an endless supply to rule over and control, to borrow here and there when we needed it, we're really kidding ourselves. Time has no master. It obeys no one. Time treats everyone equally. It plays no favorites. And it doesn't make loans to extra nice or really nice.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.